It is tricky because often it's both sides, family and patient, and they both know what's going on. And but they it's almost like they doing an act together by not telling each other the truth or trying to be extremely diplomatic, with or be very sort of I would say almost like lying to one another without really disclosing the truth. And by communicating, telling each other, you're gonna go home and we're gonna fix a huge meal for you and you're gonna be all right. And the patient's like, yeah, I look forward to that. And the hard thing is not to force that. And I think often what I do is I would speak to different individuals respectively and to see where where they're at. And I would give them that option, this freedom. Let them know there's another option, and that is to be together and be honest about this. And as much as it's hard, it does bring a lot of good towards the end of the patient's life. And often there's a little bit of resistance, as you can imagine. We cannot talk about this, it's too much. But I give them the benefit of the doubt, and I let them choose how they want to disclose, to what degree they want to disclose the news. And sometimes you'll be surprised when the time is right. They will talk to one another in their own fashion, in their own manner, in their own way of communicating with one another, and they would be able to spend time together in a meaningful way by acknowledging what really is happening.